I see Scorpios. Right. What's the pill? There's something about my camera always distracts me. Anyways, let's go into reading. Okay, so listen. Scorpios, what's happening for your relationships? You guys. New beginnings. Alright, Scorpios. Yeah, the edge. You've got the Fool's card. Yeah, the edge. You're walking off. It feels like you're walking off a cliff and you need to just trust yourself. This is new beginnings for you. You're starting new things. What I'm saying is like, even new beginnings in your family life. Some of you are just starting a family or you're building your own family. And it feels scary. You've never done this before. So it's like, and you feel like maybe you don't actually have the blueprints to do a good job. For some of you, you're becoming a two kids household. Like maybe you had one child before, now you're getting a second child, and you're like, okay, how will I balance all the responsibilities? But what's really coming through is you need to trust yourself a lot as you're moving forward into this new phase. This is a phase you've never experienced before. So you need to trust yourself, you need to be fearless, you need to do it your own way. That's very important, and it's coming out again. Like, just be yourself. Continuation from the overall reading for water signs, be yourself. This is a journey that is filled with new beginnings, it's filled with adventures, it's filled with hope, it's filled with a lot of love, a lot of passion, but you have to trust yourself, you have to be yourself. Anything that will not allow you to show up for yourself in the best way in this new beginning, you have to let it go, okay? Let it go. Trust yourself, be very fearless, have confidence within yourself. You're not going to be doing this alone. For some of you, you're going to be unexpectedly receiving support from your family. What I'm also saying is that your person, the person you're starting off this partnership with, in terms of family, this is someone you can trust. Someone that is coming through balanced emotions. Okay, for some of you, you might also be going into a business partnership. You might be going into business with your partner. Because what I'm also seeing is one of coins. And then, this is weird, but for a few of you, it's like your children or the child you're giving birth to is going to stimulate a new level of financial freedom for you. Maybe because you have to start thinking about, okay, how can I provide for this child? How can I do better for this child? It's open up your brain to more ways in which to build your assets and reach superior assets. But there's a new beginning in your finances. There's a new item. If you're not working with family right now, but I really feel strongly that it's a family. But on the other side, if you're starting a new business right now, you're also being guided to trust yourself. This is a Fool's journey. What I'm saying is, you're not being a solopreneur. If you are working on a business, then you're not working on it by yourself. This is something you're doing with someone you trust and someone who is very loyal to you. Okay? This is something you're building with someone you trust and someone who is very loyal to you. And then, what's also coming through is, some of you are working away from like a family business to start off your own business, but you're not starting off alone, you're starting off with someone else who you trust. Like, there's also someone else beside you who is giving you great advice. This person might be like a financial planner, but they're giving you great advice, like, okay, what if you do it this way? What if you do it this way? Okay, so you're trying to do things in your own way, but this is a new financial opportunity. Yeah, as I said, some of you are working away from your family business and you're figuring out, like, okay, how can I take what I've learned? My camera angle, there's something about it. This rising that is different. How can I take what I've learned? How can I use it to build something bigger? Okay, so you're being very strategic. You're being very strategic. How can I build something bigger with what I've learned? Yeah, being very curious. You know, there's a lot for you to do as you build this new business. So if it really feels like at this point in time, you're starting a new thing, a new adventure that is going to become something big. But right now, you don't know where it's going to go. So that's why you're feeling that feeling. So it feels like you're stepping off a cliff. What I'm also saying is you're being very strategic about this thing. You're being very strategic about the moves you make. But you're also being very open to new ideas. You're open to new approaches. Like, okay, if it's odd, and that's okay. So what you're saying is like, there's really no new idea under the sun. But there's something about if you go to your like great grandparents, how they did things, you see that there are some ideas you can borrow from what they did. You can borrow some ideas from what they did into what you're trying to do now. What I say is there's a lot for you to do, and this might be around a service industry, a service business, something that provides services to other people, something other people can use. So figuring out the way to provide service on a large scale, figuring out the way to provide something people can use on a large scale, that's going to almost be like the root of this new financial freedom you're planting for yourself. Okay, so they're asking me to revise what I for those of you that are pregnant or they're expecting children, that's just one part of the story actually. There's a lot here around you just, so as I said, the child, the unborn child or the incoming child, the child is stimulating your interest of, okay, I need to make more money, I need to be more financially free, I need to be more financially stable, I need to be more financially secure. What can I do? What kind of business can I do? Okay, so it's like the child or the need to provide for your family is what is creating that stimulus right now, is what is triggering your desire to build something that is going to be so almost like a mere like family dynasty. Generational wealth. That's what you're working on. You have to challenge some traditional views as you're moving forward into this thing. What is it that you think has always been done in your family, and how can you reapproach it? How can you make it something else for this new generation? How can you make it something else for this new generation? But you guys, I really see you walking away from something. For some of you, if you are currently employed, this period may find you walking away from paid employment into, okay, what can I do with my own skills on my own time? For those of you who are in paid employment, you are really thinking about, okay, what can I do on my own time with my own skills to earn money in my own way, to earn freedom, to be free to do things the way I want. So I'm free to do things the way I want. Let's get some more clarity on this. Thank you. Yeah, for some of you are considering training others, teaching others, almost like becoming a coach, becoming like a freelancer who helps other people. So that's where that service vibe is coming from. Becoming a freelancer who helps other people, that okay, this is how you can do things. What if you do this way? Because you're leveraging the knowledge of how it's been done in your family for so many times in so many ways. So you're saying, okay, what if you do it this way? What if you do it this way? You're thinking of, okay, can I transfer those my skills? Can I convert it into a course? Or can I convert it into a teaching model, or where I help people, where I become like an advisor, a coach? Do you understand? An advisor, a coach, where I'm able to teach others. Where I'm able to teach others the things I know. It's like you really don't want to be doing these tactical things anymore. You want to be more strategic. I want to move on to more strategic things. So as you're exploring these ideas, there are a lot of ideas coming through to you. Yeah, real estate is one of those. Okay, so you guys may also be considering real estate. Like, this is going to be, if you're not considering real estate before, I want you to think of real estate in your own way. This is going to be something that is going to be very abundant for you. You're starting small, yeah? You're starting small, but this is something that's going to result in massive fortune and family wealth and generational wealth if you allow yourself to be, if you allow yourself to trust the process and go with it. If you allow yourself to, there's also something about, don't just jump into real estate, commercial real estate. Look for people that burn before. This guy just came to my head. Kawasaki or very Caprisky. This guy that okay, everything's all jumbled up now. But there's this game that you can use to learn how to make money and how to invest in real estate. I'm seeing his face is a bit chubby in the cheeks. His name starts from RK. Those are his initials. Spirit, if I like this, I know she just gave the feeling for this shit. But the game is, there's this game where you play and you can learn how to move your investment, how to turn over investment, especially in real estate. Okay, so read these books, hear his stories. They're going to give you ideas on how to make this play. Alright, so this is going to be a very blessed undertaking. There's a lot for you to do, but this thing is going to be very blessed and very healing. I'm also hearing very healing for you in the way you have to provide for yourself and to provide a very structured platform for your children to build upon. So what I'm saying is generational wealth. Something that your children can always, that they'll start praising your children, your grandchildren, your great-great-grandchildren, because this is like, and I'm feeling like this is something one of your ancestors did. So two assignments for you, Scorpios. Two assignments. On one hand, look for mentors, coaches, the guy I mentioned, the game, and learn from him. On the other hand, go into your past, your ancestors, ask your oldest living relative what they can remember about your past ancestors, any of them that was involved in real estate business and real estate dealings. There's something you need to pick up from your traditional roots, from your family roots, to bring into this future, this present world. That's what I'm hearing. It's like, and it's also like the ancestor wants to contact you and share their wisdom and see about how they did it. Yeah, their ancestor wants to contact you and share their wisdom with you about how they did it. So it's like, for some of you, you may be feeling like, okay, you want to make this play alone, you don't want your family to know what you're doing, but there's something about you can ask them. Even if you don't ask them in a direct way, that ancestor wants to come through and help you, almost like maybe they want to tell you, like, okay, these were my mistakes, don't make the mistakes I did, or this were the moves I made to go big. This was how I started off, okay? But your ancestors are coming through. Oh my kumbabang, speak up. Your ancestors are coming through. For some of you, even if you don't know these ancestors or you don't have living relatives, I want you to maybe put out an ancestral altar. And just ask, sit at the ancestral altar, put foods and drinks that you know they are particular to your family, your tribe, your culture. And then just ask that, okay, the ancestor that wants to come through to help you in this new journey. And it's also like that ancestor is going to be your mentor, like an unseen mentor. But this thing you're doing is going to be very easy in the long run. An unseen mentor that helps you to figure out your shit, that helps you not make the same mistakes they did. And there's something about this thing you're doing is also going to be honoring your ancestors in a way. For some of you, if you're like immigrants, there's something about this is going to be very healing to those who fought. It's like you're going to finally be giving them a voice. So it's like that generational wealth is going to provide a long term for your future generations, but it's also going to help your ancestors, because what you do in the present is also healing what's been done in the past, is repairing the pains of the past. So it's like you becoming this So even if you are doubting yourself of how much you can become, I want you to know at this point in time, your ancestors are rooting for you. They want you to become as big. See, that billionaire status is happening. That billionaire status is happening. It's going to happen, and it's going to help your ancestors really heal their aggrieve. What I'm saying is that their aggravation is their pain. You being able to achieve this is almost going to be like the remedy, the soothing balm to all the pain they have to go through. So there's a lot for you to do. You guys may be saying 333, you may be saying 555, you may also be saying 7 7 7 2 3 2 3, as well as 333s. All right, let's wrap this up. So the blessing coming in for you. So your blessing coming in for you by this next 6 months is going to be both in your commercial endeavors, especially commercial real estate. Commercial real estate is going to investing in real estate is going to be very rewarding and very beneficial for you. Okay, so what other blessing is coming in for you at this time? So you may have Capricorn vibes. So what I'm saying is that no matter how hard it is, and at first you may feel like there's an obstacle in your way, but what I'm saying is, see, can you see that building in the valley in the field? You guys really consider commercial real estate. I'm not saying you're playing it small, like you are going into the scene and you're going to do it big. So prepare your mind from the one that this thing you're starting is something that is going to be big, and it's going to be, what I'm saying is going to be, see, that mountain is unmovable. The mountain is unmovable. It's resistance to any force of stress. So whatever obstacles are coming, as I said, in the overall rhythm, whatever obstacles may come in, see this as learning curves. They are not going to be there for you to not move through. Okay, so for some of you, you may already be thinking like, okay, maybe you don't have the money or the capital to start up. What I'm hearing is like, consider your other options. Be more strategic, like, look at all the other players in the field. Do you really need your own money to start off? There's something about using other people's money. OPM, using other people's money to start up your business, especially if it's something that is big. If you can give them the value proposition, if you can sell the value proposition, you may be surprised that a lot of people are going to be able to be like, okay, let me invest, because you're able to sell that value proposition and they're able to deliver on it. So you guys may be thinking like, okay, I don't have the resources to be able to start off. But I'm always seeing like you're not having a clear picture. So come on, you're too embedded in it now. That's why you're like, oh no, but I know I want to do this, but I don't have the money. Helicopter view, come out, take a helicopter view. Oh, I need to stretch. Come out, take a very, very high view, helicopter view, like, what are the other players in this field, in this industry around me? What are the assets I can leverage? What are the resources I can leverage to bring about this thing? What are the other things I can leverage to bring about this goal? Okay, so don't let your initial capital or your starting up fund, don't let that be. Look at what is available. It's like there are things around you, but you have to have a very helicopter view to be able to determine the other players on the scene. What are the other players that you can leverage? You guys may also be seeing 1919, as well as 2121 and 2123. All right, booking. Let's see. Final message for you. And it's interesting that the call for prayer was made at this time. Manifesting is the creative process of aligning with the energy of the universe to co-create an experience that elevates my spirit and the spirit of the world. As I said, this thing you're doing is going to be very alien for your ancestors as well.
Okay.
So manifesting is a creative process of aligning with the energies of the universe to co-create my experience. To co-create an experience that elevates my spirit and the spirit of the world. You guys may also be pulled to purple a lot. You may be pulled to wearing purple because as I was doing, it's all like I'm seeing is purple, 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 purple. You feel like these are the purples. And last thing, I let the universe catch up in my dreams. Alright, just Scorpios. I love you. You've got this. This is big business. This is a big time. You're in the big season. Don't allow your fears keep you small. It's time for you to play big. It's time for you to join the big leagues. And you can do this, okay? Trust yourself. Trust your partner. Alright, love. I love you. And for some of you, I'm told to quickly tell you, if you don't have your own yet, you might be starting off with buying your own, renovating, flipping houses. That's also something for you to consider, flipping houses. If you'd like to book a personal interview, the link is in my bio.